Good evening, one and all. I am the Reverend Ron Rye, and this is the Word at Home Watch Night Service with Kirkcaldy's own K107 FM and White's Causeway Baptist Church. And that was Celtic Worship with their 2020 release of O Holy Night. Well, folks, I will be here with you until we cross over the tinsel-wrapped hour that 12 a.m. gives us, and I'll be with you all the way through to 1 a.m. And I hope to share with you some music and some lessons, a touch of tradition sprinkled with a serving of modernity, to give you the comfort and companionship you are looking for on this, our annual celebration of Christ's birth. I want to take this opportunity to thank both K107 FM and White's Causeway Baptist Church for allowing me the time to be here with you. And I want to thank you specifically for tuning in. So, how about we share some Christmas Eve music to take us to the hour? First up is a cappella group Pentatonix with their 2015 rendition of The First Noel. Carrie Underwood takes us to Bethlehem with her take on Away in a Manger, and I do love her version with the alternative tune. And finally, the Piano Guys with The Haunting, O Come, Emmanuel.
To certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay.
Oh, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. asleep on the hay.
Night service. I'm the Reverend Ron Rye, and we're almost at Christmas. Thank you. music is played, the bells have struck, the eve is now the day. And may I be the very first to wish you, on behalf of K107FM and White's Causeway Baptist Church, a very Merry Christmas. As I said in the introduction, we're going to share some lessons and carols. So how about we get to the very first Bible reading on our list? In those days, Caesar Augustus had issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Me and my drum.
Christmas Day here on the Word at Home's Watch Night service, leading you through to 1 o'clock, and I am the Reverend Ron Rye.
Yes.
That was King's College Choir and their rendition of the Polish carol translated into English, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly. Previous to that, you heard the dulcet tones and heavy synths of Cliff Richard with Little Town. And before that, For King and Country with Little Drummer Boy. Time for another Bible verse. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Gentlemen, let nothing you dismay, for Jesus Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's powers when we were gone astray. Glad tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy, glad tidings of comfort and joy. In
Love incarnate, love divine. Star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. No.
Reverend Ron Rye, wishing you a very Merry Christmas on the Word at Home's Watch Night service leading to Christmas Day.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and joyful. Oh, come, let us.
Following the reading from Luke chapter 2, 8 to 16, was the indomitable Annie Lennox with God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. She was followed by Chris Tomlin, featuring Lauren Daigle and their original composition, Noel. And would it be Christmas Day without O Come All Ye Faithful, including that last verse, here performed by Hillsong Worship. Another Bible verse. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chiefs and chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child was with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12.
Still proceeding, guide us to So let your light shine, let your light, let your light shine, let your
to the Word at Home's Watch Night service leading you through to Christmas Day. I am the Reverend Ron Rye, and I'm wishing you a very happy Christmas.
Government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
We Three Kings was given a soulful reproduction by 10th Avenue North. Meredith Andrews called on the coming Christ with Come Thou Long Expected Jesus. And finally, Silent Night, sung live by Chris Tomlin and a congregation there, including Kristen Getty, who read the Bible verse. Well, we are almost there, but I think, excuse me, there is time for one last lesson with a couple more carols. Angels from the Realms of Glory and Hark the Herald Angels Sing, both from Paul Baloche's Christmas Worship Album, Volumes 1 and 2. But before we go, don't forget to catch me, well, in a few hours, I think, going by the clocks. Indeed, at 10 a.m. with our Christmas Day show. And from me and everyone here at both K107 FM and White's Causeway Baptist Church, I hope you have a great, a peaceful, and a joyous Christmas with all my love. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming to the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14.
Emmanuel, Emmanuel.
This is the Reverend Ron Rye from The Word at Home here on Kirkcaldy's K107 FM and White's Causeway Baptist Church, wishing you a very happy Christmas.
Yeah.